What is up guys, this is Leo from StarTech Tips and welcome to my channel. Some of you guys asked me about OTG and charging same time after seeing one of my video where I installed TP4056 lithium ion charging circuit to charge an OTG simultaneously. This charging method is working, but installing this is a bit complicated and also will lose your warranty of your tablet if you do it. So in this video, I am going to share with you a few methods by which you can implement OTG host and charging simultaneously on any device that support OTG. Method 1. Make your own OTG host plus charging cable. For this, you need a charging cable. I found Samsung data cable as the best for do modification. You also need a resistance. 100k resistance enable OTG and charging at same time. For Sony Xperia S, you may try different resistor. Different resistor value for different phones or tablet. A normal full USB has 4 pin, where a micro USB has 5 pin. Pin number 1 5 volt positive, pin number 2 data negative, pin number 3 data positive, pin number 4 ID, pin number 5 ground. Shorting this pin number 5 and 4, turn this cable into a OTG cable. Adding a resistance between pin number 4 and pin number 5, enable this cable charge and OTG simultaneously. And the value of the resistance depends on the device you are using. It might be 100k, it might be 69k ohm, but you need to figure it out what will be the value of the resistance for your device. So this is a Sony Xperia S mobile phone and this method is working here. So if you have a Sony phone, you can use this method and it barely cost any money. 100k resistant cost you a fraction of a dollar. Method 2. TP4056 lithium ion charging circuit. This is a lithium ion charging circuit. Its model number is TP4056. And it will charge a lithium ion battery. So this is a micro USB port. Attach your battery. Battery negative, battery positive here. This is the battery positive and this will be the battery negative. Now I'm thinking about if I attach this lithium ion charge controller to this battery's positive and negative terminal, it will charge the battery and simultaneously I'm able to use this OTG. I can charge this tablet from here too. Street light is turned on. So let's remove it. I bought this circuit from eBay and cost me near about $1. So if you want to buy it, you can buy from eBay. And using this circuit, you can charge any device, any mobile phone, any tablet, any device that has a lithium ion battery. Method 3. StarTech Y cable. You can buy this cable from Amazon and it little bit costly, near about $14-$15 Indian, 1100 rupees. The red is for the power and black is for going to the device you like to connect, and little one is for OTG connector. You also need a female to female USB connector to connect your USB devices with this cable. Put the power in a power bank and voila, your device is started charging. Method 4. iConnect 4 in on USB OTG cable adapter. So guys, here is the micro USB OTG charge hub for smartphone and tablet. If you want to read this feature, pause the video and read it. I tested it on my Android phone, but it doesn't work, but it working on Windows 10 tablet. So I'm addressing this on this tablet and see what happened. This micro USB OTG charger hub has 3 USB ports where you can connect any USB peripheral like pen drive, keyboard, mouse, external hard drive, etc. And this one is for connecting with the power adapter. On this side, you will see a switch where you can change a OTG mode to charging mode. OTG mode work only as a OTG USB hub, and on charging mode, OTG and charge will work simultaneously. The quality of this product is not up to the mark. The wire quality is bad and it's kind of fully plasticky. The wire feels like kind of fragile. Looking at the price point, this quality is really sucks. Connecting the OTG USB hub while charging mode is turned on. The battery is started charging. Connecting a wireless keyboard mouse. Connecting a pen drive. Then connecting a portable external hard disk. A single problem I'm facing with this OTG charger is that it providing only half ampere to this tablet, which is not sufficient for charge it up. So if I direct charge from the charger provided by the tablet, it's taking near about 1.57 ampere. On 14% charge, the tablet is consuming 1.6 ampere. If I sleep it, once sleep, it's consuming near about 1.21 amp. So if you do the math, on normal load, this tablet take near about 400 to 500 milliampere of current. HDMI connected, consuming near about 1.7 amp. I just reboot my tablet, then connect this OTG charger with this tablet and see how much current is consuming right now. It's taking right now 1.68 amp. It's pretty good, so it's going to be charged as normal. For last 2 months, I did some research and testing on some devices and came up with these 4 methods. Some of them will work for you, some of them will not. Before buying any cable, make sure this is compatible with your device. I hope this video is helpful for you guys. If I get 100 like on this video, I promise you, in my next life, I will buy every one of you a spaceship. It's not a scam, it's not fraud. I promise you, I do that for you. So please give me a thumbs up, and if you haven't subscribed to my channel, please click this sub button, and if you do it, thank you. Meet you on my next video. Bye bye.